The birth of a black hole. How does it form? The universe is a strange and mysterious place that hides hundreds of secrets and incredible phenomena. Probably this is the reason why some people are always scared when talking about space and astronauts. And what can be more frightening and attractive than a black hole? Hundreds of articles have been published on those singular objects, which happen to be the most exciting topic to study in astronomy. Last year, when the first image of a black hole was taken by the Event Horizon Telescope, showing us the fantastic hole located in the center of the M87 galaxy, the entire scientific community and even the world population was totally captivated. Imagine them like incredibly large amounts of mass gathered in small volumes with such a strong gravitational force that doesn't leave anything escape from the object, not even light. As a matter of fact, their name furnishes a good symbolic explanation. Like holes, everything continues falling in them with no way out. "Abandon all hope, ye who enter here," reads the inscription Dante placed at the gates of hell in his inferno. Indeed, this would be a good description of this phenomenon, but don't be too scared, you won't die swallowed by a black hole. Instead, have you ever thought about the origin of these objects? How can they form? Are they created only in a single way, or are there different types of formation? How long does the birth of a black hole last? How can we discover the origins of this phenomenon? These and other questions will be answered in this video, so if you are interested, stick with me and I'll tell you everything in a moment. We are going to examine one of the most important objects of modern physics. So in order to understand the topic better, we'll proceed step by step, starting from the beginning. Who firstly came out with the idea of the existence of black holes? The idea of a body so massive that even light could not escape was briefly proposed by astronomical pioneer and English clergyman John Michell in a letter published in November 1784. However, when physicists discovered the wavy nature of light in the 19th century, Michell's theory was abandoned, as it wasn't so clear how and if gravity could interact with light radiation. To sum up, let's directly move to 1915, when maybe the most fascinating theory in physics was published by a Swiss man. Do you know its name? Albert Einstein. He firstly developed special relativity in 1904, its famous Annus Mirabilis, in which he published even another article about the photoelectric effect, which was worth a future Nobel Prize in 1921. Around 10 years later, in 1915, he published General Relativity, which happens to be its most important work and one of the most crucial theory in physics. But what do General Relativity states? How we can intuitively understand such an advanced model? Shortly, Einstein tried to apply his special relativity to gravitational phenomena such as planets orbiting around a star or stars colliding at high velocities. He came out with an important result. Space and time are deformed by the mass of an object. What does it mean? Imagine the space-time continuum as a big cloth sheet. When a sphere with a mass, the sun, is put on the center, the sheet curves. If another lighter object, the Earth, tries to go on a straight line through the sheet, it starts to move circularly around the first one as a result of the curvature of the sheet. How time is deformed by the mass of a star. Time is more dilated and slowed down when it's near the object. Moreover, the heavier the body, the slower the flow of time will be. What's an important consequence of this model? Light is influenced by gravity because it must follow the curvature of space-time. As an example, if a big black hole is positioned between us and a bright star, light would deviate according to the deformation created by the mass of the hole. However, not only Einstein gave a strong contribution in discovering the theoretical existence of these objects, as a matter of fact, just a few months after the publication in 1915, the physicist Carl Schwarzschild found the solution of general relativity equations for a spherical mass and for a point mass. Just some time after Schwarzschild, Johannes Drost, a student of Hendrik Lorentz, independently gave the same solution for the point mass and wrote more extensively about its properties. This solution had a peculiar behavior at what is now called the Schwarzschild radius, where it became singular, meaning that some of the terms in the Einstein equations became infinite. What were the two main strange characteristics of these singularities? Firstly, the force of gravitation would be so great that light would be unable to escape from it, the rays falling back to the star like a stone to the Earth. Secondly, the mass would produce so much curvature of the space-time metric that space would close up around the star, leaving us outside. Therefore, the main discoveries were made in the so-called Golden Age, starting around the 60s when black holes became the most predominant and mainstream subject of research. In 1958, David Finkelstein gave the famous name of event horizon to the surface delimited by the Schwarzschild radius. What does this definition mean? Roughly speaking, the event horizon is the boundary within which the black hole's escape velocity is greater than the speed of light. To be more precise, it is the limit in which all the possible paths taken by light start to fall in the black hole with no way out. Does it seem difficult? Don't worry, here's a simple analogy. Within the event horizon, all light is directed in the hole similarly to how we move in the positive direction of time. It's an immutable order of the phenomenon that can't be altered. And do you want to know a scary thing about these strange objects? When an object falls into a black hole, any information about the shape of the object or distribution of charge on it is evenly distributed along the horizon of the black hole and is lost to outside observers. What does it mean? Practically, we can consider the object like a dissipative system, similarly to a membrane with friction or electrical resistance. Whatever disappears in the hole is totally inaccessible to external observers. This behavior is so unusual that it's known as the black hole information loss paradox. But let's move towards the main topic of this video. What is the origin of black hole? To answer this question, we need to talk about stars. Stars? Why? Because in astronomy, almost everything is linked to these breathtaking shiny celestial bodies that enlighten our dark night sky. Scientists have understood that stars have a different evolution according to their mass. They are mainly characterized by the nuclear reactions that happen in their core. Nuclear fusion is pivotal for life creation since the reactions generate enough radiation to warm the planets orbiting around and even balances the gravitational attraction that would make the celestial body collapse on itself. How is that possible? Nuclear reactions dissipate a very small part of the mass involved in the process, generating a huge energy according to the famous Einstein's equation E equals mc squared. These enormous quantities of energy are then emitted through electromagnetic radiation at different scale, visible light, UV ray, gamma rays, or microwaves. These emissions are able to heat up matter, but even to exert a tenuous pressure on particles. As a matter of fact, the radiation emitted by stars acts like a wind that balances gravitational contraction. Although the pressure of radiation is irrelevant on Earth, in space it can be observed really well. As a consequence of that, Japanese researchers in 2010 were the first to launch a probe, Icaro, that exploits stellar wind to move in space. Returning to the evolution of stars, heavier ones usually have a shorter life because they consume hydrogen and other important elements, such as helium, for nuclear reactions at a faster rate. Throughout its life, the star spends different amount of time in various stages according to the main element which is being burnt in the core. In the case of massive objects, 8 or more times heavier than our sun, the process of nuclear reactions in the core stops with the production of iron. Why? Because the fusion of its nucleus would require too much energy to happen. What is the result of this? The internal pressure of the star, which was initially given by the pressure of radiation, dramatically falls and fails to oppose to gravitational contraction, generating what we call a gravitational collapse. Practically speaking, the star collapses under its weight as there's no more pressure balancing the natural contraction. Now there's one question we need to ask. Is there an inferior limit for the collapse of the star? Well, yes, and it is linked with the extraordinary theory of quantum mechanics. The most important principle of this model is the Heisenberg uncertainty principle, which states that we can't know both the position and the momentum of a particle. More precisely, it states that the product of the uncertainty in the position and in the angular momentum of an object must be higher than a constant value. So if we know well the coordinates of a particle, we'll have a high error on its momentum and vice versa. Together with this, it's important to explain another concept, which is Pauli exclusion principle. Shortly, it states that two different fermions, which are a class of particles including the electron, cannot be in the same quantum state. What does it mean? It means that if two particles have the same position, they must have different momentum. What is the application of these principles to a collapsing star? Well, in some cases, the contraction is stopped by the so-called degeneration pressure. The more densely particles get packed together and are forced to share the same space, the more they must differ from each other in terms of their momentum. In turn, the greater the range of momentum, the greater the fraction of particles with high momentum, and these exert pressure on their surroundings. So this process allows the condensation of matter into an exotic, denser state. The result is one of the various types of compact star. Which type forms depends on the mass of the remnant of the original star left if the outer layers have been blown away. The mass of the remnant, the collapsed object that survived the explosion, can be substantially less than that of the original star. Remnants exceeding 5 solar masses are produced by stars that were over 20 solar masses before the collapse. For smaller remnants, the collapse gets to the formation of a neutron star that is a very small object composed of ultra-dense degenerated neutrons exerting a strong pressure that balances its gravitational contraction. If the mass of the remnant exceeds about 3 to 4 solar masses, either because the original star was very heavy or because the remnant collected additional mass through accretion of matter, even the degeneracy pressure of neutrons is insufficient to stop the collapse. No known mechanism is powerful enough to stop the implosion, and the object will inevitably collapse under its weight. This is the birth of a black hole. Do you want to know something extraordinary about this event? Due to time dilation, which is very significant in these massive regions of space, an external observer won't never see the end of this process. What does it mean? Practically, a person observing the collapse would see the infalling material slow and halt just above the event horizon. Light from the collapsing material takes longer and longer to reach the observer as time is strongly deformed by the high amount of mass. Thus, the external observer never sees the formation of the event horizon. Instead, the collapsing material seems to become dimmer and increasingly red-shifted, eventually fading away. In conclusion, black holes are usually formed by the remnants of a collapsing massive star more than 8 times heavier than our Sun. Therefore, a lot of problems must still be solved, mostly regarding the possible death of a black body. Many things are going to be studied to give us a proper perspective of these incredible objects that continuously swallow everything within the event horizon. This video ends here. Thanks for watching, everyone. Did you find this topic exciting? Are you amazed by the formation of a black hole? Do you think that it is possible that humanity will be able to get closer to one of these objects?